Berlin, the capital of Germany, was host to the 3D Printshow for the very first time this year. And while it wasn't the largest of 3D printing conventions, there were still plenty of exciting things to see. Starting with the printers themselves. The big brands like MakerBot and Stratasys were, of course, still doing their thing, while the smaller companies were the big attraction, quite literally. Like the Big Rep, which can print things up to an entire cubic meter in size. Printing your own furniture? No problem. A lot of the more compact printers were focusing more on speed and ease of use instead of promising too much of everything. The Italian Wasp and Danish Dynamo 3D folks both created platforms that can outperform the tried and true machines like the Ultimaker with 3 times faster print times under very specific circumstances. Oh, and of course, Ultimaker were there as well, with the 3 sizes of Ultimaker 2 they are offering now. The pocket-sized Ultimaker Go really looks tiny next to its larger brothers, but it seems to deliver the same top-notch quality you'd expect from the bigger ones. They do look very slick, but what if you want something more approachable and a bit warmer? Well, there's the II Labs Hot Rod Henry, a fused filament 3D printer styled to look like a 50s household appliance, which definitely turned out to be the most unique thing at the 3D Print Show. But plastics weren't the only thing that was being printed on the show floor. The M-Core Iris uses copy paper as the base material for its prints and prints in calibrated full color. Wasp showed a printer using ceramics, while the members of the FabLab Maastricht were using chocolates and other edible materials to 3D print food. It's not exactly Star Trek replicator material yet, but the results were definitely enjoyable. And it seems that fab labs are growing in popularity, probably in a large part thanks to the flexibility of the 3D printers that they are making available for their members. The FabLab Berlin took it a step further and is even selling their own 3D printer, which is their version of the Prusa i3. And they're printing banana holders with it, because why not? Another application that looks like it's maturing very quickly is 3D scanning, and there were 2 companies showing off what they can do today. On the one side, there was the Fuel 3D scanner, which can capture smaller areas in a single shot. On the other side, there was My3D Twin, who are doing full body 3D scanning. Where affordable scanning is probably going to make the biggest impact is with the low-cost 3D printed prosthetics shown here that were either made on expensive laser sintering machines or on highly affordable consumer 3D printers. The art gallery at the Berlin 3D Print Show was highly impressive as well. There was the entire bandwidth of 3D printed art, starting with geometric experiments, some of which involved a significant amount of manual post-processing, over super complex and detailed prints which, in terms of the overall finish, are impossible to tell from really well-made, one-off handcrafted parts, but would also be impossible to create that way. So that was the Berlin 3D Print Show 2015. If you get the chance of visiting another 3D printer near you, you should definitely go and check it out.